Welcome to RPO. In this video, we'll talk about date and time operations in Microsoft Power Automate desktop versions. Whenever we are working on any automations flow, many of the times we need to play with date and time formats. In that case, Power Automate is having some beautiful actions. By using that, we can tweak it according to our need. So how we can play around it, will show you in this video. If you wanted to learn complete Power Automate from scratch, feel free to refer my complete Power Automate playlist. If you have any suggestions or any topic which you might wanted to learn from this channel, feel free to add in the comment sections. We'll be happy to create videos related to that topics based on the demand. Creating a new flow, you have to just click on new flow, add the flow name, click on create. This will take few seconds to add the flow within your instance, and after that you can start working on it. Just write date, and here you will see in the action sections you will see add to date time. Here if you will drag and drop, you will see date time options are available. Subtract dates, get current dates. Work on this first, we'll need get current date and time. So in that case, you will have options current date and time, which you can also modify to current date only. Time zone, you can select any specific time zone, or you want to add system time zone on Windows time zone or custom input, anything works fine. Whenever it will save into the current date and time variable, and after that, you can use for other variables. So let's say you wanted to add something into the date time format. So here I will just use this one and add 2 days, and then that's the result. Now here I will message box. In this message box, we'll add 2 message box. One, it will display current date and time, and second message box, I wanted to display the final result. Let me run it. Now you can see my current date is this, because I have selected date only. That's the reason it's showing 00. We can also trim it with some customization. So with some adjustment, we can do it. Now it will add 2 days. It will become exactly 2 days. It means 24. Now it's showing 26. Similar way, we can also subtract it. Let me go to the actions. Now here we'll use current date and time, subtract 3 days. We can also select any options like minutes, hours. Let me subtract it 3 hours here, but here we have to select date and time both. Now what will be the output? So here I will remove this one. Time difference is a variable which is generated earlier. Now, once I will run it, I will get options. So this is the time now. You can see of the system time, 24 of Feb at 5 p.m., 5:30 p.m. It will add 2 days for now. And after that, we have just made some mistakes. So I have to get even the proper date informant, then only it will work for subtract dates. Otherwise, it will not work. That's why we can modify it at any point of time whenever it's needed. Even you can also use convert date in time to this. Here you will get convert date in time to some other text. And once this text is converted, we can use it. We need to use the convert date in time format to the string. That's only it will work, otherwise it will not. So that's how we can build operations using Microsoft Power Automate desktop versions and work on the date and time operations. That's all from this video. Hope you enjoyed the content. If you think so, this will be useful, don't forget to share within your circle. And if you have any suggestions or feedback about content, or if you want to learn any new topic which is not available on our channel, feel free to add in the comment sections. We'll definitely come up based on the demands. Thank you.